Payment forms are another type of form that you'll likely use in your product. You want to keep these simple and easy to use so that way the user can focus on purchasing the product. You'll also want to provide different payment options. This form looks a little long, but at least there are different options for payment. Gumroad is a startup that does this really well. Gumroad connects sellers of digital products to buyers. You could sell or buy a variety of things on Gumroad. Let's say I wanted to buy a music management book. I can click on I want this, and I get redirected to the simplest payment form. However, don't mistake simplicity for lack of design. The devil is in the details with this form, and there are so many great details. The price for the item is clearly displayed here. Input placeholders describe what each field should contain, and even on the credit card, we can see that the format hints at the spacing between groups of four numbers. I also need to enter a two-digit month, a two-digit year, and a CV code. When I start typing in my payment information, the form selects the credit card that I'm using. Don't worry, this isn't my credit card. Many credit card companies have reserved prefixes. Eventually, I'll need to enter a CV code as well, and this form tells me where to find it. For Visa, it's on the back of the credit card. For other credit cards, such as American Express, we can see that the CV code is on the front of the credit card. Now, the one thing missing from this form is some indication of trust. There's a lockdown here, but I don't really know what this means. Another website called UXPen reminds users about security and encryption on their payment form. Some other sites use logos like these to remind users about secure payment methods. These types of details increase conversions and make for great user experiences. They can make your users love not only your product, but also how they buy it.